In this video, I want to share with you how to use Quora. Okay, Quora is a very interesting social media question and answer platform that is generated by people. Okay, it's a people place platform to answer to ask questions and people place to answer questions. So if you have a question, you can come to Quora and put it up as a question. It's like other social media platform, but it's duly or clearly handled by people this time around. So you could come here and ask the question, and you have people who have answers about that question from different part of the world, and they'll help you to answer. So it's a people platform. People ask question and people answer the question, and questions become much more authentic as they are getting upvotes accordingly. So to start on Quora, Quora is a very good source of traffic for your websites, for your YouTube channel, and for different kind of media. If you are targeting to increase traffic or to bring in more traffic source to your website or to your content, Quora is a very, very good place to start. Okay, so to start with, you can just come to Quora.com. As a new user or as a fresh user, you can come to continue with a Google account. If you have a Google account, you can log in, or if you have a Facebook, you can log in with Facebook. Or you can just sign up with your email. If you don't have a Gmail or you don't have a Facebook account, you can just sign up with your Gmail. And once you sign up, follow the process. Once you're done signing up, you can just come over here and just put in your email and password to log in. So once you click to log in, and it will just, let's check the logout, the main page on the other side. So you have to select at least three spaces to follow. Okay, at least five spaces to follow. So once you select those spaces, it's going to bring you over here. So this is like the home page, just like the way we have on Facebook and LinkedIn and many more. Okay, so at the top here you have the home page where you have everything at the normal stage. Over here you have the following. These are people you are following, because you have to follow people just like the way you follow people on Instagram, you follow people on LinkedIn and Facebook and something like that. And over here you have all your answers. If you post a question and someone answers it, you will find it here. Okay, once you click on this, it will show you the answer, and you see all the spaces you have created. Spaces are like group platforms that you have people comment, or people bring in different topics and they comment over there, and it keeps growing. So you can create spaces, you can follow spaces as well. You can, over here you can create a space, and you can see other spaces that I'm following currently. Okay, so you have notifications over here, and you have a bunch of things that anything that comes in or related to your Quora account is going to be popped up over here. And over here you can search on Quora. So Quora is also functions like a search engine. So if you have a question, you may not necessarily go to Google to ask. You can come to Quora and you can just search for the question over here. So for example, I can ask, okay, you can who invented Facebook? Who invented Facebook, Libra, or all this? Okay, these are similar questions that you can actually search to follow around. So over here you have your profile picture, and if you want to add a question, you can want to ask a question, you can click on this to ask a question. So it functions more or less like the social media, like what you have on Facebook. If you want to create a post, you can come over here. What do you want to ask or share? You can ask a question or you can share something just to attract people. So the first thing is, you can just click on this and you can ask your question. Start with what, how, and why. This is just signifies that this is a question, and you can specify who this question gets to. Is it the public or just limited people? All right, you can specify this. And over here add a question, you can click on this and you can create a post, and you can create a post from here as well, so people can see and maybe can comment or the above. So to add a question also, you can just come over here to this red icon and just click on it, and it's the same thing. You can add a question, you can start with this feature, and you can just ask to the public or to specific group of people. And to create spaces, you can check out the spaces I have created. And so to improve your feed, to improve what comes in your feed, you have to come over here and follow four more spaces. So you have to follow four more spaces. So you click on this to see a bunch of spaces, suggested spaces to follow: marketing, making money online, express entry to Canada, full funded scholarships and health issues, British Council's free IELTS preparation materials, investing for beginners, online marketing. So just check out, maybe let's say I follow this, making money online, and I can just follow this space. You can see the number of followers they have. So you followed one, So you have to follow at least 6. So express entry to Canada, maybe I select this one and then I just follow. Let's say we check another one. Fully funded scholarships, let's say British councils, let's say online marketing, like online marketing. So let's follow and then follow this. So this is the third one. You have to follow the fourth one, which is afterlife, IELTS, writing and speaking. So let's say we follow IELTS, writing and speaking. So you just follow. And these are spaces created by people. If you want to create your own space also, it's like a page. Okay, so you want to create your own space also, you can, and people will follow it. Okay, so once you're done, you can close and you can always refresh your page, and you can see the space, the following of spaces is checked out. Now you have to upvote at least 5 more good pieces. So you upvoting is like recommending a particular answer. So you have to upvote at least 5 more to signify that your account, to improve your feed on, or to improve on what comes on into your account. So authenticating like 3 more topics. So let's say we want to authenticate at least 3 topics from the content. So let's try, let's say entry, express entry. So we check an early one. So let's say this one, you can downvote, you can upvote. Okay, so downvoting also means like downgrading the value, or you are not so interested, it's not so catchy, it's not so you don't recommend it. Okay, simply you don't recommend it. So upvoting, let's say we upvote this one, and let's say we kind of check around and find one more. Becoming a subscriber, and let's just find one more and upvote again. Okay, so let's say this guy, Silicon Valley to Nepal, let's just upvote him. Upvote, so 2. So we have to upvote at least 5. So let's come back and maybe let's try higher education, and select any 2 to upvote. So let's say we upvote this one, upvote this, and upvote this, and I think we are done. We got up to our 5 needed upvotes. So when we refresh the page, we come back to Quora, and you can see that is checked out as well. So you can see that it's checked off. And the next thing, you have to add 3 credentials to you. So you can add credentials to improve, because this is a question and answer platform. If you add a credentials to yourself, it brings in more value and it adds more value to the content you share. So if you are a CEO or if you are a PhD holder, when you talk, it takes more value when you add those credentials to your profile. Okay, so let's say we add credentials. So you have to add a credentials. So for example, employment, education, location, spaces, topic, language, you can add all these. Okay, so you can put in your education, you can put university degrees, where you finish from, and all that. And down here you could put all other employment, maybe currently where do you work. Okay, you put your position, you put the company, you start, put start year and end year. Oh, I'm currently working here. Okay, so for example, let's say I'm the CEO of Epic Mentorship. All right, Epic Mentorship. And start here, you can say 2019. And let's say I currently work here. Okay, so you save this. So you can see this, it's going to add, your credentials have been added. You can add other credentials as well, location, spaces, you can add all these, and it's going to improve your feeds over here. So these are some of the key things that you can add, and you just start posting and you start answering questions. So anytime you ask, you have a question, you can just come to add a question, and you can just type, what is the requirement for YouTube monetization? So as you are typing, you'll be able to see some suggestions. So if the question had been asked before, you will be able to see it, and you see the sample answer that had been given. So you don't need to duplicate the question, you can easily go to the question and see the kind of answer. If it's not still satisfied to you, you can just a little bit model it again, and then you can send it out to people. You think the new YouTube monetization requirements are the best? What are the minimum requirements for opening a new YouTube channel for monetization? What did YouTube raise? Why did YouTube raise the monetization requirements? And many more. Can I appeal to YouTube for my monetization? So these are questions, but they don't answer your question directly. And then you can go ahead and just post your question. Okay. What is the requirement for YouTube YouTube monetization? You can say yes, you can go with the suggestion, or you can ask original question. You say yeah, go with the suggestion. Okay, so you find an answer, you have about 6 answers for you. and you can easily view the answers and check them out. If it's okay for you, you can check the answers here. And one answer already, you have to get 4,000 watch hours and you have to get 1,000 subscribers, and this is good, and you can just give him an upvote. So ladies and gentlemen, this is just a bit on how to use Quora, and you can always come back to the homepage over here. So once you post the question, you can always see your answers over here. Whatever question you put, you can see the answers over here. So if you have different kind of content, you can use Quora as a very good source to attract people to your website, because you can answer questions to people, you can answer people questions that people ask, and you can use your link to your videos maybe to refer them to watch this video maybe about this question that they have asked, and it could be a very good source of traffic to your website. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, this is a bit about Quora and how to use it. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.